Wow. We're absolutely wrecked. We just got here yesterday, but we're already planning a little party for the day.
There's nothing like coming back into town and having Sharon prepare a feast. Okay, we woke up late today and I was just like, oh my gosh. I could like barely even make coffee.
And after a day like today, he needs brown. Yeah.
We had the luxury of coming back. We had to get the keys to get into the little area where our van is, and Sharon had a survival pack with some brownies and some fruit. She had food for Frank, which was a lifesaver because we had no food for Frank. Everything just worked out perfectly. Sharon is our guardian angel.
Okay. All vegetables from the garden.
Okay.
This is chicken kebab.
This is amazing. So what are we celebrating today?
My house.
Your house. And this is like a ceremony to bless the house?
Yes, this woman over here is making an offering to Pachamama to bless our house.
Oh, I love it.
And we're thanking Pachamama for permitting us to use natural materials and the land.
Got done eating this enormous breakfast brunch that was so delicious. I definitely overate, and now that I'm completely stuffed, they decided to tell us that there's cake.
Not for you. This is world famous Ulrike's cake. This is not just any cake. This is our birthday, our belated birthday cake, Trent.
That's right. And you're at early
places. This is Capricorn birthday cake.
Capricorn celebration.
And it's to celebrate
Capricorn
cake.
You're just a big puppy dog. You just want some love.
We had a very insane trip getting here. If you guys watched our last video of the crazy flights, the extra 12 hours of travel, the near-death experience, we'll link it if you haven't watched it. Go give it a watch. And that all happened yesterday. So today it's been less than 24 hours later, but we're trying to just regroup, be grounded, be really grateful that we made it all in one piece. We've actually met someone really special already. Her name is Aline. She was introduced to us by Sharon, and we met her this morning at Sharon's despacho ceremony. The place that we're going is way up in the mountains, so we're actually taking a cab.
We're not going to the mountains.
Oh no, I don't even know where we're going or what we're doing.
We're going to another town.
Aline, do you want to introduce yourself and say hello to the vlog?
I'm Aline Love. Hello.
And basically, Aline is our tour guide for today. It's incredible. And you're taking us to somewhere very special. What are we doing and where are we going?
Okay, so we're going to a small town called Wasau. It's actually known for the curanderas and curanderos, which are the healers. That's the word for healer.
I love it.
Curandera is a female healer whom we're about to see, who's somebody very, very special. Her name is Vilma, and she has traveled all over the world. She does a lot of despachos. She does coca leaf readings.
So as you guys know, yesterday we had this kind of crazy near-death experience, and today I think we're feeling very open to hearing what Vilma might have to say to us about why we survived and what we're even doing here.
That's great. Have you ever had any kind of reading before?
I had like a tarot card reading one time. It could have been very accurate, but it's like about details of my life that I know nothing about, so there's things yet to be discovered.
Ah, I see.
So we'll see.
Right, yeah.
Thank you.
Allie's son. Mm-hmm. Number 3. What a beautiful number. My friend Allison, very sensitive woman. In your life, it's not just stay in one place. In your life is to travel different places. I see you. You have the energy of the eagle. And the eagle for us and the condor here is to connect with all over the world. It's not just with one place. In your life is to be a leader, to be a teacher, to help people, to support people, to teach. Very sensitive person in your life, very supportive man. So in life, in the family, you took the role of father. Mm-hmm. Because for your age also, it's like you are a very protective person. You have the same energy like mama. Mm-hmm.
That was really intense.
That was not at all what I was expecting.
Yeah. I mean, this is like sounds so cliche, but she like told us a lot of things that like there's no way she would know those things about me or even about Allie. And
she asked us to write down, so we each went in separately. She asked us to write down our name, birthday, place where we were born, and place where we live, and that's it. We didn't exchange any other words. She knew nothing about us, and she took these coca leaves and crunched them in her hands and asked me to blow on them, each of us to blow on them 3 times, and then sprinkles them in front of us, and then just reads the way that they fall and the way that each leaf looks. I've never seen anything like that before.
Yeah, that was special.
Yeah.
I'm really glad we came here. It's like one of those, like I was like really scared actually when I went in there. And it was like had like a very nervous feeling, and then it was like very calming afterwards, so it's really cool. I'm really glad we did that.
Yeah, and I mean, who knows how much of this is real, right? It's always fair to have some amount of skepticism, but
it's up to your interpretation.
It's up to you, of course. But what I heard hit me really hard.
Yeah.
It was intense.
Yeah. What was your overall
experience?
What was your
overall?
It was
good, like it's not raining anymore.
Positive. Good.
And now we've got to get back to Sharon's house. Well, we made it back to the van safely. It was a nice little ride in the dark. It kind of started raining, but we made it back. Now Allie is enjoying one of her favorite activities.
This is the best.
Allie decided to leave the door open about 6 inches while I took Frank to the bathroom. When
Big
I came
mistake.
Back, 1,000 flying bugs in the van.
Yeah.
So now Allie's trying to kill all the bugs with the fly swatter.
It's pretty satisfying. If you don't have an electric fly swatter, you should get yourself one pronto. So on our way back from the tea reading with the shaman just now, we shared a cab with Aline, and it was like an hour-long drive, maybe 45 minutes. So we got to talking, and it led to astrology somehow, and she's really big into star charts and birth charts, and she knows all the astrology signs. And Trent's a Capricorn, I'm a Scorpio, and she actually did like a whole birth chart for each of us and analyzed like our compatibility and our moon signs and Mars and Venus and all these different things. So crazy. I've never really like been super into astrology, but it's so crazy how accurate some of the stuff she was talking about was.
She's also a Capricorn, Aline, so she knows all the Capricorn traits, and then she was just listing off all the things that I am, and Allie's like, yep, yep, yep. So I think it was good. A lot of the things that she talked about where me and Allie are compatible just like totally makes sense. I mean, me and Allie have obviously known this for so long, but seeing something with the astrology, like, I don't know if you believe that or not, but it was pretty interesting.
It was crazy because, like, for Trent's sun sign is a Capricorn, but then his moon sign, which I guess is, like, your emotional state, was a Scorpio. And my sun sign is a Scorpio. So I guess, like, we're already pretty in tune with each other. And then my moon sign was a Taurus, which is pretty close to Capricorn. So we're, like, kind of already each other's signs. So I guess we get each other.
If you couldn't tell already. We had an amazing time today. It just goes to show that meeting Aline was a huge treat. We got to go on this adventure and go get the coca leaves read, and then we learned all about our star signs. And this
so
is
cool.
All branched off from Sharon, and Sharon is one of the most amazing people ever.
The more we learn about Sharon, the more in awe of her I am. She is like a magical human being.
We haven't asked permission for us to share any of her life story that she's told us, but
it's
the things that she told us has absolutely blown our mind.
We're feeling super grateful and super small, I think. Like, just part of this. The more we learn, I feel like, the less we know.
Yeah.
And today was one of those days where I feel like we know nothing.
Yeah. Cool. I was super grateful for today.
Yeah.
And super grateful for each and every one of you guys watching. Yeah. So thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it.
We love you guys. Thank you.
See you guys in the next one.
Adios.